Mr. Fernandez.
Hi, can I help you?
Yeah, Mr. Fernandez. I'm sorry to bother you. I hope I didn't burst in on a family.
No, I was just hanging out with the kids right now.
Okay, do you have a minute?
Sure.
Hi, I'm Tom Hagan. I represent a client in New York City. I'm an attorney. And we have a favor that we'd like to ask you of you and Fernandez Films. And in return, I think there are a few things come up that we can help you with.
What favor might that be?
We need Johnny Fontane to star in that new war picture that you're starting over at Fernandez Films.
Johnny Fontane, never. And how might you be able to help me?
Well, we understand that you may have some labor problems coming, going on at the moment. We have some union people who may be able to help you out. And other than that, we've just learned that one of your top stars switched from marijuana to heroin.
You're trying to muscle me.
No, it's not like that. It's not like that. I represent one client, Vito Corleone.
Mr. Hagan, why didn't you tell me you were associated with Mr. Corleone? Let's take a walk.
Well, I don't like to use my client's name unless it's absolutely necessary.
I thought you were some kind of two-bit thug that Fontane sent up here to muscle me out.
Oh, no, it's not like that. Absolutely not. I'm an attorney. Listen,
I want to show you something rather beautiful. Come with me. Do you appreciate beauty?
I've been known to enjoy the finer things.
Let me show you something. There she is. $600,000. I'll probably never race him, though. I'll just put him out to stud.
Yeah, he sure is beautiful. I can see what attracted you to him. Listen, Mr. Fernandez. Don Corleone is John Fontaine's godfather. And in the Italian culture, it's a very sacred, religious, and honorable thing. And, the Don kind of promised Johnny that he'd do anything within his power to get him this job.
Listen, you can ask me anything else, but Johnny Fontane will never be in another one of my pictures. Johnny Fontane ran off with the girl I love. He made me look ridiculous. A man in my position cannot be made to look ridiculous.
Well, unfortunately, Mr. Fernandez, there is no other favor we need. And I'm sorry, I have to go now because the Don, he prefers to hear bad news as soon as possible.
I'm sorry, I can't help you out.
So we won't be hearing back from you?
We're done.
Thank you for your time, sir.
Jerry, what do you mean, man? You want to go for a swim? Come on.